was alone. Wow. A weird first thought to have. Thomas decided to start listing his observations for posterity. 1. The whole alone thing. 2. Portals. They led somewhere. He'd yet to work out where. 3. Falling. Thomas was absolutely fantastic at falling. He was almost as good at falling as he was at observing. Okay, interesting. Thomas couldn't fall past this block. Think, damn it, think. What if there was some kind of inverted fall? Some way to... what's the word? A big jump. But Thomas noted there was no real danger in missing it. The world didn't want him to fail here. It was pushing him, but gently. Come. This all seemed a little dangerous. The world was not to be trusted. It was unstable, and it seemed to Thomas that it could let him down at any moment. He was starting to suspect. Thomas wondered whether the portals were actually taking him anywhere. He felt like he was making progress, but there wasn't really any way to know. He seemed to be moving predominantly up and to the right, which might or might not be important. It might have been paranoia again, but Thomas could have sworn the world was becoming more complicated. It always seemed to be one step ahead of his skills. It had been designed just for him. He wondered why. Was the world testing him? No, too obvious. Something about the boiling, toxic, glowing water intimidated Thomas. He didn't like it. He certainly didn't want to swim in it. He made another mental note. The loneliness was getting to Thomas. No amount of observation or obsessive note-taking could combat that. Had a new theory. The world was training him. He could feel himself getting smarter. There was the mental list to consider. Over the minutes and seconds since his spontaneous generation, he'd become a pretty skilled jumper. He was evolving. He just wished he had someone to share it with. Dislike to the skinny red rectangle. Who the hell did this Thomas think he was? Chris had been doing fine. He wasn't the highest jumper, but he'd held his own. He'd even been graceful at times. Well, not actually. Technically graceful, it's probably the wrong word, but you know, fine. There was that skinny little runt leaping about like he owned the place. Chris could get to it, which of course made it all the more enticing. What would it do? What new opportunity might this switch open up to him? Slightly higher than Chris. How fortunate. Seriously, this made the whole switch pressing thing entirely worthwhile. Was this good? Because on the surface, it did not seem good. Chris was pretty scared. Little Red seemed fine, happy to be on his merry little adventure. Chris couldn't shake the feeling that things had taken a significant turn for the worse since Thomas had joined him. Sure, he'd been able to piggyback his way to ever so slightly higher platforms, but where had that got him? Well, to ever so slightly higher platforms, which was sort of his point. He seemed so very happy at their situation. Friends together, a brave fellowship of quadrilaterals on a quest for greatness. That would be fine. But it was all the obvious observation that Thomas was doing which grated. Every time they saw something vaguely new, Chris would hear a satisfied little from the vaulting idiot. He hoped the next portal would split them up. If only for a few levels. This would not do. John needed room to show off his exceptional skills. As it was, he was trapped on the wrong side of these little dot things. Where did they come from, anyway? John inhaled the air of the open space, and it smelled of awesome. Time to flex those muscles, to put his training to use. Time to show those little dots how it was done. John decided to press the switch, to let the little dots catch up with him. John cared for his new allies. You could tell from the sympathetic expression he practiced in the mirror all these years. It was important to his image that he was seen to help the little guys. Thank you. so much either. The red one, Thomas, had a charming way of applauding every time John jumped. Immediately likeable, but his unremitting cynicism and tutting amused John. This would require coordination, balance, and timing. John was sure the dots would be lost, but he was happy to guide them to triumph. What the dots were for. They were there to extend John's reach, to make his performance even more impressive. John liked the thought. He decided to keep them.